I know you're angry, but we don't have the luxury of playing it safe. Your brother understood that. Mason, we need your help. There's new info in your guerrilla handbook that will be useful. The EDF's hold on each sector varies. Bring up your map to see the control value for each sector. Successfully completing guerrilla actions like raids drives control down. So does destroying EDF property, which is shown in red on your map. We've identified targets that are key to EDF operations. The ones marked as medium importance cause a bigger control drop when destroyed. A few are marked as high importance. Those require some planning before you hit them, and will turn into a hornet's nest when you do. But the payoff is big. Each sector also has missions which are required for liberation. Drop the control to zero, complete all the missions, and the EDF will pull out. If we're going to defeat the EDF, we need the support of the people. To do that, we have to raise morale in each sector. Morale goes up as you complete guerrilla actions, destroy EDF propaganda, and a few other things you'll discover along the way. However, when a colonist is killed, that sector's morale drops, so be careful. As morale in a sector increases, ammo crates will be better stocked and colonists will begin to fight alongside you. Also, the amount of salvage you get for completing a mission will increase if morale in the sector is high. Higher morale means more ammo, more help, and more salvage. Three crucial elements we need to succeed.
To do this job right, pay attention to your surroundings and use what's in front of you. Oh, and make sure you're out of the blast radius.
Thank you.
With the right tools, you can make an impossible task look easy. And then afterwards, you can talk about how awesome you are.
The enemy wants to know who ambushed that patrol and are interrogating the locals. Can you help them out?
Get you out of here.
Leave me alone, you bastard!
It's all right. I'm here.